Good morning, students. Today we'll start the chapter Popular Beliefs and Religious Debates. In this chapter, we will discuss about which major religious cults, doctrine, and sects became popular in the subcontinent during the medieval period. Why was the tradition of worship and devotion called bhakti? The common features of the bhakti traditions, and who were the famous bhakti sons? If we talk about medieval period, in India, people worship God generally in two ways. The first way is to recite mantras and perform various rituals under the guidance of priest, or they participated in singing and chanting in large group in the praise of deities. In the first method of worship, they require priest to worship God. But in the second method of worship, they don't require any priest. The second method of worship attracted several people and made them feel that they were equal members of the same community. Now let's understand the meaning of the bhakti and its origin. Let's understand meaning of bhakti. Bhakti means single-minded, intense devotion to God. It was a complete surrender of oneself to God. The movement which emphasized primary these ideas was the bhakti movement, devotion to God. Bhakti to God was accepted as salvation. In other words, we can say that the method of worshipping or offering prayers to the God through simple acts of devotion is called the bhakti tradition of worship. Bhakti means selfless love for God. The idea was first expressed in the Bhagavad Gita, but it became widespread in the early centuries of the Common Era. You must have studied in class 6th that according to traditional Hinduism, human beings were born unequal. And those who were born in noble families or high caste could have authority and power. But Bhakti sons rejected these inequality based on the caste and also all the rituals. And they taught all these things and wrote in local language spoken by ordinary people so that these local people can understand. Now, how these Bhakti tradition begin? Apart from the two largest group, that is Hinduism and Islam, other new sectors and belief also came into being. And the common people started expressing their devotion to God generally by taking part in the activities organized by the local group. Let's understand some of the important features of the Bhakti movement. Belief in one God, brotherhood, emotional worship, good deeds, Guru's rule, and no caste system are some of the important features of the Bhakti movement. Now let's discuss about some of the most important Bhakti movement sons. We'll start with the Alvars and Nayanars. Between the 7th and 9th centuries, Bhakti movement came into the foreground in southern India through the preaching of Alvars and Nayanars. Now, who were Alvars and Nayanars? Alvars were the followers of Vishnu and Nayanars were the followers of Shiva. Most of them came from the lowest caste and some of them were even women. They composed beautiful poems in Tamil and they preached that selfless love to Shiva or Vishnu was the only path to reach God. Now let's discuss variety in the movement. There were a great variety of teaching through the Bhakti movement as it developed in South India between the 7th and 12th century. We'll discuss Shankaracharya first. Shankaracharya was born in present-day Kerala. And what he preached? He preached that the principle of Advaita or oneness of the individual soul with the God. Advaita means oneness of the individual soul with the God. World around us is Maya or illusion. According to Shankaracharya, world around us is Maya or illusion, and we should follow the path of knowledge as the only route to God. And liberation of soul can be achieved when the Atma unite with the Brahma. Atma means the soul of an individual and Brahma means the super soul. Ramanuja, another famous saint of the medieval period. He was born in Tamil Nadu in the 11th century. According to Ramanuja, when the human soul become one with the Supreme God, it maintain its own identity. According to him, devotion to Vishnu was the only means to salvation. Madhav, Shrikanta and Vallabhacharya were the famous sant of the Bhakti tradition who talk about the connection between the Atma and Brahma in different ways. Now let's talk about Virshabhasam. Baswana and his companion Akma Mahadevi and Alma Prabhu began Virshabhya movement. Movement began in Karnataka. They said that all human beings were equal and they criticized inequality based on caste and gender. They also did not believe in rituals and idol worship. Marathi Bhakti poets. Between the 13th and 17th century, many sant or poets such as Janeshwar, Namdev, Eknath and Tukaram, women such as Sakubai and the family of Chokha Mela from Maharashtra inspired people to follow the Bhakti of Vithla temple in Fadharpur as well as that of the God that live in the people's heart. They rejected all kind of rituals, unnecessary display of deity and discrimination on the basis of caste. They rejected the concept of renouncing the world, preferred to stay with their families and serve fellow humans. This was a new form of bhakti where happiness was in sharing the pain of others. So students, now it's time for some brainstorming exercise. So let's start. What does bhakti means? Who were Alvars and Nayanars? And what did Shankaracharya preach? So students, give me the answers of these questions in the comment section below. So students, rest of the chapter we will do in the next video. Thank you and have a good day.